ఆదిభ్యో బ్రహ్మ విద్యా సంప్రదాయ కర్తృభ్యో వంశర్షభ్యో మహద్భ్యో నమో గురుభ్యః సర్వోపప్లవరహిత ప్రజ్ఞాన గణ ప్రత్యగర్థో బ్రహ్మాహమస్మి సోహమస్మి బ్రహ్మాహమస్మి. ఓం ప్రపన్న పారిజాతాయ తోత్ర వేత్రైక పాణయే జ్ఞానముద్రాయ కృష్ణాయ గీతామృతదుఖే నమః. ఓం నమో వెంకటేశాయ. మై బెస్ట్ విషెస్ అండ్ పరిపూర్ణ ఆశీర్వాదంస్ టు ఆల్ ద వ్యూవర్స్ ఆఫ్ శ్రీ వెంకటేశ్వర భక్తి ఛానల్. మే ద ఆల్ మైటి శ్రీ లార్డ్ వెంకటేశ్వర బిస్టో ఆల్ కైండ్స్ ఆఫ్ ప్రాస్పరిటీ, హెల్త్, వెల్త్ అండ్ ఎటర్నల్ హ్యాపీనెస్ విత్ పరిపూర్ణ లక్ష్మీ కటాక్షన్స్ టు యూ అండ్ ఎంటైర్ యువర్ ఫ్యామిలీ మెంబర్స్ అండ్ ఫ్రెండ్స్. లెట్ అస్ బిగిన్ భగవద్గీత వర్స్ నంబర్ 4 ఇన్ ద 7th చాప్టర్. శ్రీ భగవాన్ ఉవాచ భూమిరాపో నలో వాయుః ఖం మనో బుద్ధిరేవ చ అహంకార ఇతి యం మే భిన్నా ప్రకృతిరష్టధా. ఫ్రమ్ దిస్ వర్డ్స్ ఆన్ వర్డ్స్ టిల్ 12th వర్డ్స్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ చాప్టర్ భగవాన్ కృష్ణ ఇస్ గోయింగ్ టు డీల్ విత్ ఈశ్వర స్వరూపం, ది నేచర్ ఆఫ్ గాడ్. Now this teaching or the fact about the God remains not depending on our belief system. We need not to believe the God. Nobody will come and will say you have to believe the God. In India we give it to their own choice. If you accept there is God, your life changes tremendously, marvelously, and it goes entirely towards the goal. The concept of God doesn't depend on you. Even the methodology of this teaching is also not dependent on our belief system. Any culture, any society, or any concept which only depended on human belief cannot remain longer, because the concept of the God is nothing but the fact of the universe. This is like a kind of result of a math. So math needs a formula derivation, so you can also pick the answer immediately, but that derivation is very important, that formula, step by step, step by step, step by step. So when you go by step, that fruit will become meaningful and worthful. So this Ramanuja has given the answer for so many mathematical aspects, but still people are struggling to find the derivation. In the same way, this is not only dependent on human belief. The teaching which Bhagavan is going to teach, it is not only dependent on our belief system. That we have to understand first. So what is human belief system? We have, you know, two kinds of belief. These two kinds of belief, we call it blind faith or faith. Blind belief and belief. According to the scriptures, the belief itself is blind. So when you will use that belief, belief is a kind of faith. So it's a kind of what? Hope. That hope which is unknown to you, that you have a thought, yes, it is possible. You give a chance to that existence for something. If somebody says there is Badrinath, you believe it. But if you deny it, then that person says, if you deny or not, there is Badrinath. But until you reach the Badrinath, then alone you can confirm there is a place called Badrinath. But if you accept the person says, then you will gain a knowledge. That knowledge will be useful to you. In the same way, the God is nothing but a fact. The fact, if you accept, you will be benefited. And there are so many beliefs. We also have, you know, even in a foreign countries, number 13 is considered as a kind of devil's number. They don't like 13 number. I heard that, I'm not very sure, but even few airlines, they don't have the row of 13 number. In the theaters, in some of the place, they don't have the 13 number as the row. After 12, immediately 14 comes. So what it is known as? Is it a faith or it is a blind faith? If you go to bed to sleep with the faith that you would get up in the morning, is it a blind faith or faith? If some food, you know, when you go to India in so many places, different dishes. If you come to South, the idli, rice, dal, chutney, these things are very famous. If you go to North, there butter paneer masala, our rotis, tandooris, and so many, the naan, butter naan, so all these things are famous over there. If a person goes to North from South, he wants to do experiment of that food. When he has them, with the belief that he could digest, nothing won't happen. Now the human life is based on only belief. Okay? Now you cannot say there is a blind belief or that open eye belief. With open eye, with consciousness, when you believe that itself called blind, you are completely unknown about that entity which you believe on. Therefore, and even in the cricket, when match is on, there are so many superstitions. So the particular color, particular people, particular place, they have to sit like this. If they change the leg, then the boundary comes or sixer comes. They should keep the leg for a long time in that position itself. So these are all called superstition, accepted by the people. Why this God concept is not accepted by many people? Because it's not visible. The result is not visible to others. There is result. When you accept God, that result can be experienced by your own mind and buddhi. But you are not ready. Because a superstitions on all other beliefs, they see the proof of other people. Even in this 13 number, you know, when you started believing, it happens. When you believe, something happens. That belief itself a kind of magic. Now, Bhagavan says, I don't depend on your belief system. If you believe, you will be benefited. That is the secret of the teaching. Now, when he says, the world is created by God, it means what? The God should have been before the world. If God should have been before the creation of the world, now where is the God after the creation? The question arises. It's a normal question. And I tell you, there are so many people, they are great bhaktas. In India, I have seen, you know, so many people, they are very great devotees of the Lord. After certain years, they drop the belief and they become non-believer of the God. When you accept the God, so only don't use bhakti. That's not bhakti at all. Bhakti should be backed with that, the knowledge of the fact. Therefore, inquiry is very important role to play when you accept the God. There is a text called Vichara Sagaram, the ocean of inquiry. The religion, the concept of the God gives or provides a space for your all kinds of analysis, questions and answers, debates. Debates means what I mean to say, samvada. Not with prejudice. Now bhakti is a great thing, but bhakti is not enough, because bhakti can only fructify complete fruit when it is backed up by the knowledge which is constructed upon the inquiry, why, what, when, then these all questions must be answered. Now there is a world. So when it was created, the question should arise. How it was created, who created it, and with what kind of equipments that he created it. Now God is introduced as a power. That power has got two kinds of principles. One is known as apara prakriti, another is known as para prakriti. Now once you accept, yes, there was a God before the creation, he created the world, then you can understand this theory. And this theory is not only based on human belief. I am repeating again and again. Why? Because many people get failure here. They say that I believe the God, I don't want to study these kind of scriptures. Need not to study. No. If you have not undergone the inquiry, the scriptural studies, your belief can change in a day because your mind and body sense complex are not solid enough to continue the belief even if you are getting so many struggling in your life. Therefore, the inquiry about the creation, the inquiry on the Creator is very much required. Now we are doing the inquiry on this visible world. Through the inquiry of the visible world, we are going to have inquiry on the non-visible Creator. That Creator, when he created, so that what kind of procedure he followed, Taittiriya Upanishad says, Tasmade tasmad atmana akashas sambhutaha akashad vayuhu vayo ragnihi agmerapaha adhya prithvi prithvya moshadhayaha oshadibhyonam annat purushaha. There is a krama, there is a sequence of it. So these eight kinds of aspects which is introduced in this verse, they are not the visible five elemental world. They are the subtle, the first level, I can say intermediary level creation. The creation was created not in gross way, in subtle form. So only this original five elements were created first. Pure earth, pure water, pure fire, pure air, pure space. What this pure water and etc. means, it's the original form which is the first creation. That's what he say. That is named as apara prakriti. Bhagavan Krishna has brought this concept from Sankhya Yoga. The Sankhya Yoga which was created by Kapila Rishi. We call it Kapila Muni. That Kapila Muni has created this paddhati called Sankhya philosophy. In the Sankhya philosophy, the world has got eight aspects. Now here, Bhumi means earth, means not this earth, this original earth. In the same way, Bhumi is the original earth, original water, because the earth which is experienced by us, it is mix up of all four aspects with this earth aspects. That I will tell elaborately in future, so you don't get confused. The earth which we see, in that earth entity, so water entity and fire entity, air entity, space entity, everything is being mixed up. That mixer is known as a grossification. That grossified five elements alone can be experienced by our system, because this system has been manufactured through that grossification alone. Therefore, the system doesn't have the capacity to see the original of this grossified world. Therefore, what the world is. World has been divided into eight aspects. That eight aspects, so which came first? So which was created by the God known as apara prakriti, lower prakriti. That's what is introduced here. And there is one more prakriti known as para prakriti, which will be introduced in the next words. Let us read it. Apar eyamitastvanyam prakritim vidhi me param jiva bhuta mahabaho yayedam dharyate jagat. When he introduces this para prakriti, he introduces by which the earth is sustained. Now, this para prakriti, that by which the world is dharyate, sustained. Now, apara prakriti and para prakriti, two prakriti have been introduced. And among this, or in between these two prakriti, what is the difference? The para prakriti and apara prakriti. So, para prakriti doesn't have form, nirguna vastu. Nirguna vastu means there is no attributes. Apara prakriti is a saguna vastu. Now you see, this is nirgunam, this is sagunam. And this is chetanam, this is achetanam. Para prakriti, which is chetana vastu, conscious vastu, which is nothing but the consciousness. And this apara prakriti, which is jadam, inert vastu. Now we have seen two kinds of differences. The first is this para prakriti, which doesn't have form. And apara prakriti, which is endowed with the form, attributes, guna sahitaha. And this para prakriti, which is nothing but consciousness. This apara prakriti is inert. And this para prakriti, which exists independently, then apara prakriti, which doesn't have independence, it has to depend on the consciousness alone. And final difference is the para prakriti is nirvikaraha, it doesn't undergo any modifications, and apara prakriti, which undergo always modifications. So this para prakriti and apara prakriti, both are called Ishvara Swarupam. And what we will get out of this understanding is Ishvara means what? Para prakriti and apara prakriti. Para prakriti means what? That which is in the form of consciousness. Apara prakriti means what? That which is in the form of all these names and forms. Okay, now this Ishvara Swarupam must be understood more. He says, Jiva Bhuta Mahabahu Yedam Dharyate Jagat. The para prakriti becomes the Asthivara foundation. Apara prakriti is constructed on that. Now this apara prakriti is dependent on this para prakriti. That is the understanding one should get. The next words, Yetad yonini bhutani sarvani tupadharaya aham krishnasya jagataha prabhava pralayastatha. This para prakriti is known as yoni, the source for entire creation. Not only that entity is nothing but me. Nothing but me means what? Nothing but the consciousness which is experienced in the form of me, me, me in every individual body. So it is a beautifully get connected, but this one session, please, you have to be very careful. Don't let your mind to get deviated. Because when Bhagavan has introduced, there are two kinds of prakriti, just fix in your mind. So you need not to get confused, only para and apara. And para, which is in the form of consciousness, apara, which is in the form of the created gross materials. Our body, mind and sense complex are what? Created, which is known as apara prakriti, and all this entire world and activity. The earth is keep on rotating, traveling in its orbit. It means what? That earth grossified entity, and the orbit which is also grossified entity. Therefore, all the flow of the river, when sun shines, you know, it burns for a long years. Years means it is a trillion, billions years. Because of which? Because of the consciousness. There is one source in all these forces. That force is the source of all these activities or functions. The earth goes and all other planets, so they keep on rotating, and that rotation also, or when it revolves, it has got its own sequence, its own rhythm, and the level of density, everything is fixed in a way in the consciousness. Now the consciousness becomes that center point of all kind of activities. So like your consciousness, our consciousness becomes center point of all our activity, experiences, incidents or accidents. In the same way, this, the para prakriti, becomes center. But that para prakriti is not only called Ishvara, even apara prakriti also known as Ishvara. Now, we can say the science also divides into two things, the creation, matter and consciousness. In between this matter and consciousness, when they divide, they also fix the connections between these two, like the scripture also does. But Bhagavan Krishna, he will say, why it is connected, how it is connected. So because when you see gross things, it looks more stronger than the consciousness. Okay, but the consciousness is more powerful than, even it is the base of the matter, doesn't matter how strong it is, but it will be perishable. So one is nityam, another is anityam. This para prakriti, which doesn't undergo any modifications, this apara prakriti, which has to go under modifications. Now the world, the creation has been divided into two categories. Now the consciousness, so where it exists in all the materials. Now the apara prakriti is anisyuta, means pervaded by the para prakriti, which is consciousness. Now apara prakriti and para prakriti, they are not separate. When you look at the world, this apara and para, both aspects seems to be one and the same. Now you should have the proper understanding. So every apara prakriti, every product, it has got the source of the product within that. Now that para prakriti cannot be taken away from the apara prakriti. If you take an apple, it seems to be grossified material, isn't it? So if you want to, you know, keep or take the consciousness, which is called the para prakriti, away, then this material cannot exist. That is the connection. The connection, because this apple is dependent completely on the source of apple, isn't it? In the same way, the world is completely dependent on the source of it. That source is known as para prakriti of Ishvara. Now people will say that source alone, God. Then, so what is the apara prakriti, srishti, created material? Material is not other than the God. You have to remember the example which I said of this web and spider. The web was not different than the spider. Okay, in the same way, may there would be, or there might have been, the God alone, When he created the world, and that world is not separated from the God, the God is all pervaded in the world. So this is what inquiry is. So merely if you are getting a love towards Lord Balaji, Lord Sri Ranganatha, Parthasarathi, and that is great. But that bhakti, that love, it has to be supported by the inquiry of the God concept. Then you can enjoy. Then your belief, when you don't have that much energy to believe, then alone your buddhi will accept. Your buddhi will say whether you believe or not, there is God. That is the secret here. He says, Yetad yonini bhutani sarvani iti padharaya. You have to understand, you have to accept. This becomes the source which paraprakriti, from the paraprakriti, this aparaprakriti is manifested, which is known as a creation, and it is sustained, and it is done with dissolution, pralaya, then srishti. That's what he says, jagataha prabhavaha pralayastatha. And he adds one more word, aham krishnasya jagataha prabhava pralayastatha. There is no conclusion in these words. We have to go to the next words to find the proper meaning, because he says, from me alone everything is created, and to me alone everything being dissolved. So that aspect to be understood, because I am very slowly taking steps one by one, because you should not feel it is heavy. We will continue this Ishvara Swarupam, because this is the main part of whole Bhagavad Gita. Okay? This whole Bhagavad Gita is dependent on these verses. There are 4 to 12. I think 4 to 12 means only 9 verses. These 9 verses must be assimilated well. We will continue, and we will definitely assimilate by the grace of Ishvara alone. So let us pray for that to Balaji. He may bestow a kind of complete energy to assimilate and receive this knowledge. Harihi Om. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Harihi Om. Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om.